Hi. I'm Roxanne. I was another one of Tony's really good friends. I know Pete said he didn't plan on crying during his speech. I did plan on crying during my speech, but that's okay. So, if anyone knows Tony, you know she was pretty weird. And she was really into, like, crystals and crystal magic, and she didn't really ever relay enough of it to me for us to understand it. But while all of this was going on, maybe a month and a half ago, or pretty early on, at the end of our rope and out of people to call, we thought, well, maybe we just should ask a psychic. And so we drove to Topeka and found a psychic. And we went into it saying that we weren't going to say anything about it because we didn't want her to have bias. We had many psychics reach out to us, but I wanted to see what happened if we reached out to the other side. And the psychic was a complete loss. She only wanted to talk about my dating life, which is a sore subject. And so I didn't feel like I had any business sharing Tony's business with this crazy old woman. And one question she asked me, and she didn't even ask it, she said, "You're going to a wedding soon." And I said, "No." And then she said, "No, I think so." But I had no wedding plans, no invitations, and no friends with guys good enough to marry them, so I didn't know what was going to happen. And fast forward a month, last Thursday night, I went to sleep, and I see Tony in my dreams a lot. But usually, it's fuzzy, or I can't talk to her, I can't access her. But in this dream, I was at a wedding, and all of a sudden, Tony appears in front of me at the reception. She goes, "Sorry, I was late." And I asked Tony, "Where have you been?" And she said, "I've been home." And I woke up in the morning, and that was pretty much the end of the dream. I gave her a big hug, and I woke up, and I told my friends, and I said, "Tony told me that she's home and that she's safe." And then that night, that Friday night, they found her car in the river. Oh. And I know that Tony was trying to tell me that she's been home. Tony was always bigger than the earth here. She was more, she has reached her earthly potential. She was the happiest person I know. I've known her since sixth grade, and when she went, she was the happiest she'd ever been in her life. And I think now Tony's just one with the universe, and I think she'll visit us all in our dreams, and we'll see Tony in every warm summer day, every good thing, every blessing that happens on earth, because Tony lives in everything that she loved. And it's clear that she touched so many people. And so to have you all here today, just to visualize just one iota of the lives she touched, the impact she had, and the love that she had to give, it just means a lot. And I thank you all for coming, and I hope Tony visits you all in your dreams too.